Yeah, go ahead.
Okay.
Just because it's your turn.
So how much more money?
I am, but I just don't.
But it just makes them uncomfortable.
I get it. Because you want them to think you're not.
Does it?
The kid, right?
So how will we get the lowdown on what's not included? Because I don't have.
This was a good one.
See, I didn't see it, but my paper's.
Page seven.
Oh, wow.
So it'll be this.
The little guy looks like. Right?
I think I have something like.
Think so?
I think Zach and Jamie were.
Okay, so man.
More like me.
Yeah, Brody definitely looks like him today. He's on the Holland, smiling.
Okay, we good to go?
Yes, I think we are.
Okay, we'll call the meeting to order at 6:04 PM. We'll go ahead and stand for the pledge of the flag.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Communication to the board. We have special matters and recognition. One, we'd like to thank Joe Levesque, who is retiring from our board after 5 years of service. Thank you very much, Joe. We have a teacher retirement. Jennifer Higgins.
I'm going to try not to break that.
You're not off the hot seat yet.
Oh.
Whoa.
Oh,
I like that. That's nice and loud. So, the last couple of weeks have certainly been an emotional roller coaster for me as the principal over at the elementary school. We've had UPK graduation, kindergarten celebration, sixth grade moving up day. I have the honor of appointing a terrific teacher for tenure tonight, and now a retirement. So this last couple of weeks have been quite a journey. Life is full of ups and downs, beginnings and ends, and tonight is bittersweet because this week marks the end of a treasured teacher and her time here, Jenny Higgins. What can you say about a teacher who's given nearly 20 years to the district and the people of Holland? Not nearly enough to capture the impact that she's made. Mrs. Higgins has always been a hard worker, dedicated to her students and her school. She designs creative lessons day in and day out to push her students to achieve, all the while when maintaining a welcoming and nurturing environment for children. She's always willing to lend a hand when anyone's in need or volunteer for after-school events, and who can forget Professor Higginstein's laboratory. While we are happy for Jenny and everything that she has accomplished here in her time at Holland, the void that she will leave is impossible to fill. Congratulations to you on your retirement. Good luck, and we will miss you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Very nice. Appreciate it. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I don't even know where to begin to sum up 17 years in this lovely district. The people, the children, the administration have all been incredibly supportive. And that's what's made it quite difficult for me to say goodbye. I thought I would leave a year ago, but things weren't quite right, and we waited another year. It's been an incredible run, and you have allowed me to be myself and to do the theater and to do fun nights and do whatever I wanted to do, and it's all been so fantastic. So I do want to thank the board for hiring me in the first place and for allowing me to have such a great ride. I appreciate it very much. Thank you.
Um, The PTO has a gift for Jenny on the PTO's behalf. She's been a very dedicated member to our PTO, and we're dearly going to miss her and Professor Hagelstein at our events. So, Nate, if you could bring the gift up.
A touch of nerves.
Yes.
Nathan is one of my students, one of my best students, my favorites. And I'm very proud of you, Nathan.
Thank you, sweetie.
Thank you, Jenny.
Next, we have teacher tenure recipients, Ms. Angela Wallagora, Ms. Angela May, Ms. Melanie Stephen, Kelly Zimmerman, Ashley Momeritz, and Amanda Jasper. Jason's going to again come up and say a few words.
I'm younger and a little bit quicker, so I got up here first. Come on, I had to. So now on to a more happy event. Miss Angela May, come on down.
I don't know how I can follow that, but.
I don't think you can. So anyway, Miss May is eligible for tenure, receiving tenure tonight. She's had quite the journey here in Holland. Was here for a while and then had to move and then was lucky enough to be able to come back. And now it's my pleasure to be able to recommend her for tenure. Currently, she teaches as a math AIS teacher, and she is a tremendous asset to our school and our district. She creates a bright, positive, student-centered classroom environment, designs engaging lessons for her students, which are fun and challenging at the same time. She goes above and beyond in literally everything she does. She's part of the PTO. She provides additional learning experiences for our students, such as the Tech Guru Club, and she works on various STEM projects with students as well. And beyond what she does here in Holland, she's also dedicated to her profession and takes time to participate with the Erie Cattaraugus Teacher Center, and is, I believe, is on the board there as well. It is my pleasure to be able to recommend her for tenure. She is going to be a tremendous asset to the district for years to come.
Okay, now the old guy who's much taller. As you can see, I did need to adjust the stand. As a matter of fact, and go a little bit higher. Nice guy. All right, I have the pleasure of speaking about five teachers in my building at the junior senior high school. And their journey was just as extensive, but I'm very pleased to present them to the Board of Education for your approval for tenure. So if Amanda Jasper, oh, she's not here tonight. She had an emergency with her family, okay. Ashley Momeritz, front and center, please. Okay, Ashley teaches 7th and 8th grade math, and her content knowledge is excellent, outstanding. She also came to us with technological skills. And she was one of the first teachers when we started with the iPads to start working with the iPad in the classroom. And we're very pleased with her work. She volunteers to participate on committees. She's also the 7th and 8th grade student government advisor. And she's always available to help kids. And she teaches 7th and 8th grade math. So I'd like to present to you Mrs. Ashley Momeritz. Angela Wallagora, front and center. Angela teaches a section of eighth grade ELA, but also is the freshman English teacher in our building. And the amazing thing about Angela is that she teaches our kids at that grade level, or at that age, to think critically. Start thinking outside the box, read a piece of text, analyze that text, and be able to write, not only write, but also defend what you're looking at, and do it in such a way that kids stand back and say, wow, I can't believe I did that. She's always available for students before and after school. She was part of our district committee that began writing the rubrics, the writing rubrics for the district, and she's also the freshman advisor for the freshman class. So once again, I'd like to present to you Mrs. Angela Walagora. Kelly Zimmerman. Kelly is our 7th and 8th grade art teacher. She also teaches a section of studio and art, adaptive art, and also our yearbook class, and she's also the yearbook advisor. When you walk into Kelly's classes, there is just a lot of movement. Kids are working individually at their own pace. It's lively. She's moving from front to back, and she works with kids individually and also in groups. And the way that they produce artworks that you've seen posted throughout our building is just simply amazing. And I'm just very, very pleased to have Kelly as part of our art staff here. Once again, I would like to present to you Ms. Kelly Zimmerman. And finally, Ms. Melanie Stephen. Melanie is part of our special education staff. And the unique thing about Melanie, when she first came here, she worked with a group of juniors, and they had to take the English 11 Regents exam. And to her credit, she got all those students through. And I was just amazed how she breaks the lessons down. She differentiates her instruction in order for some of our neediest students to understand the concepts, but also be able to take an exam like a Regents English exam and pass it. So my hat is off to Melanie. She's a hard worker. She establishes goals for her students, and she is available before and after school. She also reaches out to parents, and also she's one of our district tutors that also tutors kids that are on medical and or long-term, what would you say, suspensions from school. So I'd like to introduce to you Ms. Melanie Stephen, and congratulations. And that's it for me.
We're gonna take a brief recess for reception.
Can I say something first?
Oh, yes, absolutely.
Real quick. Congratulations to Joe, I guess, on your kind of retirement. It's been a pleasure getting to know you. It's been a pleasure working with you. We'll miss you. Jenny, congratulations, but I know you have plans for your next venture, so I'm sure you've already been planning it, knowing you, and are ready to roll immediately. Thank you for your service to Holland. It's been a pleasure working with you, and I wish you well. To the rest of the teachers, welcome to now the vetted Holland staff. Congratulations. It's very clear, and we're very happy with you, and it's very clear that we're adding very valuable educators and out-of-the-box creative thinkers to our staff. So again, welcome and congratulations to each of you. Now you can recess.
Okay. Can I have a motion to recess?
So moved.
A second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay, we're going to move a second.